sometimes most of us want to go on vacation. We might choose to go on the yacht for a cruise. But the beauty of it is seeing these water bodies. My research is working on offshore structures, working on water. Water has a lot of energy, it's quite powerful. If boats, for instance, are not built in streamlined shapes, there will be a lot of water shedding effects on these boats, which could actually cause some pressure damages and vortex effects around it. But I'm not looking at the body of these vessels, I'm looking at the pipes used for drilling oils on these structures on sea. I'm looking at composite risers. Composite risers are risers, they are pipes, they are conduits used to drill oil and fluids, not just oil, they also transport fluids from the seabeds up to the vessels and down. Now, looking at composite risers, they are very important because one of the reasons is that composite riser technology is an enabling technology, but it's not facing out steel risers. Steel, which we all know, is a benchmark material, it's very strong, but composites also are better in this technology, being that composite risers are light. At the same time, they have good fatigue resistance that has to do with even the way we use them in forming shapes. But in my own research at the same time, I'm also using titanium. Titanium is a very nice material for reinforcing this composite riser because it is lighter than steel. Steel has a density of about 7,925 kilograms per meter cube, but titanium itself has a density of 4,500 kilograms per meter cube. You see, with this, it tells you that composite materials are lighter and they are better to use. Most technologies now in offshore technology has been moving into the offshore stream, into deep waters, because deep waters are waters that are over 1,000 meters. And right now, most technology moving towards there has been the best. And right now, I'm doing this with some industry, and we're looking at developing more materials like PEEK and AS4. Thank you very much.